Hi, this is COMP1010 at the University of Manitoba. I'm Dr. Celine LaTulip. In this short video, I'll go over a few common bugs you might encounter when programming with while loops. So have a look at this code. We have a variable called numTimes. It's an int and it's initialized to 0. And then we have a while loop. And the condition on the while loop is numTimes less than or equal to 10. Well, numTimes starts off as 0 and 0 is less than or equal to 10. So this condition will initially be true. And then we're going to print out numTimes, which means we'll print out 0. And then we'll come back up and we'll test again. And so if you look at this at first glance, you think this is going to print the numbers 0 up to 10. But there is a problem here. You might notice that we're missing an upkeep statement. So we have nothing in this code that causes numTimes to change. And that means numTimes is always going to be 0. So 0 less than or equal 10 is always going to be true. And we will keep on doing this and printing 0 over and over again forever. This is what we call an infinite loop, and it's really problematic. So let's have a look in processing at what this looks like. Here we have numTimes equals 0. This is the exact same code. We run this and we see we're just getting tons and tons and tons and tons of zeros, and it's not stopping until we stop the program. So in order to actually correct this, we need to change numTimes. And so in this case, if we increment numTimes by using the plus plus operator and we run this again, now we see that we print out the values up until 10 and then we stop. And we see that this is working because each time when we're printing, this value is changing. All right, so that's an infinite loop and that's how we might fix that one. All right, next, look at this code. Here we have an integer variable I equals 10. We're testing whether 10 is greater than 100, printing out I and decrementing I. So this looks like we're going to print numbers down until we hit 100. The problem here is with our initialization code. This I equals 10 means that this will never be true because 10 is not greater than 100. So right away, this is not going to be true. We're going to skip it and go down here. This whole loop might as well not be here because this code right here is wrong and the loop is never executing. It's never even running once. Okay, so let's have a look at that in processing. Here we have it, and I equals 10, and we run this, and you'll see that actually there's no output whatsoever. Now, if we set this to be 150, for example, and we run it, then we see that we've actually printed out the numbers from 150 down to 100, and the loop has run a bunch of times. So sometimes if your loop isn't running at all, it's because you've messed up with your initialization code. Okay, last example. This one's a little bit more complicated. Here we have an active drawing script in processing. We've got our setup function, which sets our canvas size. We've got a draw function, and we have a mouse pressed function. The mouse pressed function sets this Boolean draw dots to false. Here's the Boolean declared up here. In our draw function, each frame we're going to set dot count to 0, and then we have an expression here, a while loop with this condition. And this is a compound Boolean condition, so there's two parts, and it's an and condition, so both parts have to be true for the whole expression to be true. So we have draw dots, which is our Boolean, and then we're checking to see whether dot count is less than 10. So dot count starts off as 0, so 0 is less than 10, so this part is fine. And draw dots is the Boolean, so we combine these two Booleans, and if they're both true, the whole expression is true. And then we're going to choose a fill color, choose a random location to draw the dot, and we're going to increment dot count. So this should draw 10 dots in random locations with a random reddish color during each frame. And then it's going to become, draw dots is going to become false when the mouse is pressed. And as soon as the mouse is pressed and this is false, the whole thing becomes false and we stop drawing dots. So you might look at this and think, okay, I think this looks good, but we are missing one thing. And that is the fact that draw dots up here is not initialized correctly. So let's go and look at what this looks like in processing when we run that. So here's our code. Draw dots is not initialized. We have our setup and we have our draw and we have our mouse pressed function. And if we run this, we have a blank screen. So nothing is happening. We're not getting any dots at all. And that's because we haven't properly initialized draw dots. And in this case, the compiler didn't catch it, probably because this initialization or this variable declaration is so far removed from where we're first using it that the compiler can't tell. It thinks maybe this has been initialized somewhere. So it's not actually giving us a compile error. What we're getting is what we would call a runtime logic error because we didn't initialize this. And so this is coming in and it's false. And so no dots are being drawn. As soon as we initialize this to true and we run this, now we've got lots of dots. It keeps on drawing dots until we click the button. I just clicked and then it stopped. Okay, so you have to be careful about making sure that if you're using Booleans in your expressions inside of a while loop, that you have properly initialized those Booleans, because if the Boolean hasn't been given a value, you can't really predict what will happen. All right, so those are three common problems with while loops: having an infinite loop because you haven't actually changed a variable that's in the condition, also having a bad initialization that means the loop never runs at all, and then having poorly initialized Boolean variables that cause problems. So watch out for those problems and good luck with your while loops. Thanks for watching.